Vajrayana Buddhism appear in many forms throughout the sacred art of Tibet. They appear as sculpted images called rupas, or form, and on cotton cloth paintings called tankas. Who are they, and what do they represent? Is this idolatry, devil worship, magic, demonology? Or are we dealing with psychic principles of a far higher order? The Tibetans do not consider the deities to exist outside the mind. And yet, the mind being all, that is the most powerful existence there can be. It will be hard for many of us to comprehend the directness with which the Tibetans have symbolized the various energies latent and active in the mind. These symbols contain the essence of all the concepts leading to ultimate enlightenment, nirvana, the formless state beyond all conception. The deities are focal awarenesses or crystallizations of all that is contained in the word compassion, or the phrase boundless light. They are not idols, demons, or gods, as we of medieval Western thought conceive of such things. Magic? Yes, there is magic. Everything we see and hear as reality is a magical show, a shifting play of illusion, clinging to sensual perceptions. The mind visualizes the peaceful or the wrathful aspects of itself. The Tibetans merely painted all this as lessons, and the deities are stepping stones to these truths. The Buddha, Gautama Shakyamuni, the historical Buddha, one of countless Buddhas throughout time. The gestures of the hands, called mudras, symbolize meditation, generosity, and the so-called earth witness position used by the Buddha at the time of his enlightenment, calling the earth to witness his resistance of the temptations of Mara, the power of evil.
Thank you.
Amitabha, boundless light. The mind body, or Dharmakaya of the Buddha. We are here face to face with a high form of Buddha doctrine, seeing a symbolic representation of a Buddha form that in ultimate terms is beyond depiction, beyond imagination, beyond thought, boundless light. Avalokiteshvara, the high disciple or bodhisattva of infinite compassion, proceeds from Amitabha, the boundless light, whose image often appears in the headdress of Avalokiteshvara. Many heads are needed to see into all the suffering realms of existence. Many arms are needed to reach out to sentient beings in torment. And here we meet the bodhisattva vow, the noble promise to wait until all beings have been helped to attain enlightenment before himself entering into final, ultimate nirvana, never to return to the futile rounds of birth, death, and rebirth, over and over through countless eons of clinging, misery, and suffering. Through skillful means, Avalokiteshvara changes into many forms to aid the suffering. Wherever one senses a presence of unsentimental compassion, seeking no return of favors, there the essence of Avalokiteshvara is present among the affairs of man. The lotus born. He is the embodiment of all the Buddha qualities, a of all the Buddhas throughout time. He represents the unending as well as the beginningless Buddha urge to transcend the obsession of materialistic worldviews. The glorification body and the transformation body of the Buddhas into one magnification of supreme energy. His is the only force powerful enough to sustain beings through dark times, known, as is our present age, as the Kali Yuga. Padmasambhava brought Buddhism to Tibet, and his emanations are now bringing the Vajrayana teachings to the Western world. His is the force which reaches out, compounded of diamond-like, indestructible energies, those qualities which grow even harder under great pressures, and which cannot conceivably ever die, because they are also unborn, and do not partake of that illusory flame and ash cycle known as life and death. Manjushri, Bodhisattva of wisdom. He bears a two-edged sword. One blade cuts through confusion, the other ignorance. In wrathful appearance, he has the power to subdue death. Ha 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 ha!
chant. Om Yamandaga Om Pad Om Yamandaga Om Pad Om Yamandaga Om Pad.
Yamantaka, a wrathful emanation of Manjushri, is a force powerful enough to subdue man's most haunting illusions, death and time. Vajrasattva, chief of the five meditation Buddhas, contains a purifying aspect associated with the heart center. In one hand, he holds the Vajra, diamond scepter symbolizing skillful means. In the other, he holds the Gantra bell, symbol of wisdom. Together, the bell and Vajra combine the male and female energies necessary to attain supreme awareness. Vajrapani, the combined energy of all the Buddhas.
Om Vajrapani Om, Om Vajrapani Om, Om Vajrapani Om.
Chakra Samvira, the female yogic energy or Tantra, which is being raised within the practitioner of meditation. Vajrabhirava is the female form of Yamantaka, conqueror of death. She also subdues hatred. Her symbolism portrays her ability to bring about an awareness of transiency in all things. A skull cup of blood signifies the passing frailty of men's bodies. Who but a fool would put great store in such vanities? Tara, the protectress and mother of all Buddhas. her feminine form of gentle wisdom, provides the sanctuary that shields us from life's aggressive forces. Thus, she becomes a womb wherein the Buddha to be transcends all perception of aggression. Mahakala, defender of the teachings, was not always so. In pre-Buddhist Tibet, Mahakala was indeed a demon. Padmasambhava converted Mahakala to the Dharma, and his energy is now available to the practitioner of Vajrayana. It is especially useful in defending one's practice from worldly seductions and maliciousness. We are being shown a world of sensual pleasures and earthly destroyers, a world of death and rapine, which a virulent force such as Mahakala's can detach us from before we are totally submerged in it. Rahula, also a defender of the Dharma. Gesar of Ling, a mythical hero king of Tibet, whose deeds form the only source of non-sacred Tibetan literature. Bhava Chakra, the wheel of life, central doctrinal portrait of Buddhist belief. At the heart of suffering are lust, anger, and stupidity, symbolized by rooster, snake, and pig, from which arise the world of ignorance of animals, the world of humans of passion, the world of jealous gods of envy, the world of possessiveness, of hungry ghosts, the world of anger, of hell. A chain of causes keeps us turning around on this wheel of life, one hallucination leading to another, like the succession of the months or the zodiac, always returning to round it again, never clear of the karmic winds that force our lives out of our own hands. How do we ever escape this round of existence? Some will say, who wants to escape? Some will say, where is there to go? If you don't exist, what good is that? We have arrived at the very heart of the matter. What has caused that turning about in the deepest seat of consciousness in millions of Buddhists? When and why and how did they all decide to turn toward a path leading away from all forms of phenomenal pleasure and pain, light and dark, good and bad, and to end that frivolous, tragic comic game? Who told them there was another way, that it was worth the effort necessary to tread that path? Who told them how to proceed? Some will say that it was the Buddha, Shakyamuni. Others, perhaps the Tibetans foremost among them, will say, in words or chanting prayers, in painted works of art, and especially in the lives they lead, that these questions, as well as the answers, proceed from bodhicitta, the seed of enlightenment that lies in each creature, man as well as animals, that awaits only the awakening rain of meditation to grow of its own accord. In early stages of spiritual progress, perhaps common people will rely on deities as gods who are personal protectors. But later they will transcend simple-minded religion and find they are themselves fully in charge of their own choices and destinies and have it all within the grasp of their own minds. So say the Tibetans, perhaps the most religious and creative people since the Egyptians. So they painted and sculpted their beliefs. And so, they say, is the force of Buddha activity that continues in all people throughout all ages without ever waning.